Boating hazards are everywhere right now. Some of those hazards, like debris, are still left over from Hurricane Irma. That was more than 7 months ago. The Coast Guard took NBC2's Brittany Weiner out on the water to point out all the potential dangers as the temperatures heat up.
Even months after Hurricane Irma, there are still some hazards from this storm that you need to look out for, like here at Bowditch Point, where the shoaling is starting to move into the channel. Coast Guard members stationed on Fort Myers Beach.
Right now we're in the back bay.
Taking us out on the water.
Up here, we have a few sunken vessels.
To point out hazards of navigation.
Ops are normal. Some people might not see them at night because sunken vessels, you're usually not lit.
Weather usually stirs up these hazards.
Most of the time it's after storms.
Like Hurricane Irma.
Parts of docks, vessels that had sunk.
But it doesn't take hurricane strength to move items into a boater's path.
There could be debris that's lodged or just sitting partially submerged under the water where any kind of force can move it around.
Storms can also change the layout under the water.
It has changed the way the sandbar's been poking out.
At Bowditch Point, sand started building out after Irma.
There's been a lot of sand buildup coming into the channel, so it's probably something they're going to have to come out and dredge eventually.
And hitting a sandbar on a boat?
It's like hitting a wall.
But the Coast Guard is always keeping an eye out, and they'll mark or remove any reported hazard. But they rely on boaters to help them stay up to date.
We rely mainly on the mariners to let us know where these hazards of navigation are.
They keep a weekly log that they recommend every boater checks, along with the forecast before taking on the water. And if you need to report a hazard on the water, there's an app for that. Just download the Coast Guard app and go to Report Hazard. Reporting on Fort Myers Beach, Brittany Weiner, NBC2.